population of our planet is projected to reach 9 billion by the year 2040. Adding this many new faces brings both hope and challenges, including more mouths to feed in a world where 1 out of every 9 people already don't have enough to eat.
With limited lands and agricultural resources at our disposal, how can we help those who already struggle to eat, as well as feed the new faces in the years to come?
One answer is water. 1/3 of the world's food is produced under irrigation. While water seems plentiful, with oceans surrounding all of our continents, securing an adequate supply of fresh water, especially in arid places, is a growing challenge. Droughts have claimed more than 500,000 lives in the last 35 years, and around the globe, farmers desperately need new sources of water for the world's food supply. Could the salty ocean water hold answers to our food supply challenges? Most commercial crops are irrigated with relatively clean water, taken from groundwater, rivers and lakes, or treated sources. Salt water is harmful to most plants and animals, yet a trip to the beach underscores that a variety of plant life can thrive with the ocean as its water source. Can we learn something from those plants and apply it to crops such as wheat, rice, corn, or soy?
In the famous Galapagos Island, researchers have discovered wild tomatoes that grow near the ocean, splashed with seawater. Can we learn how they cope with these tough conditions and apply this to other crops?
We've sequenced the genome of 200 of these wild tomatoes that have salinity tolerance, and we can now breed these into the domesticated tomatoes that have got the big fruit that we like to eat, with the aim of being able to move the salinity tolerance into the domesticated tomatoes so then they can be grown on seawater or at least half seawater that's been diluted with a bit of fresh water.
Breeding these plants to extract the desired salt-tolerant properties is similar to farming techniques used for hundreds of years to grow bigger and better crops. The same principle that allow us to produce more corn per acre could lead to our ability to grow tomatoes and other crops using seawater for irrigation.
Quinoa is a nutrient-rich food that could be a staple crop, making a major contribution to food production globally. It's also incredibly tough. There are many varieties which are both salt-tolerant and heat-tolerant. We're trying to discover the genes for those traits of heat and salt tolerance with the aim of developing crops that can grow in this type of region, in this very hot, salty environment.
What we've learned from a few wild species could potentially help us create hybrid crops that can tolerate seawater irrigation and help us feed a growing and hungry planet.